A ref cursor which has fixed return type is called a strong ref cursor, and the one that doesn't have fixed return type is called a weak ref cursor. We have discussed both these types in the previous tutorials. Apart from these two types, we have one more type, that is sysref cursor. We are going to learn about it in today's tutorial. What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another PLSQL tutorial. In today's tutorial, we will learn about PLSQL sysref cursor in Oracle database. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. Sysref cursor is a predefined weak ref cursor which comes built in with the Oracle database software. As we saw in the previous tutorial, that creating a weak ref cursor is a two-step process. First, you have to create the weak ref cursor type, and then you have to create a cursor variable using that ref cursor. Sysref cursor can save you from all this hard work. When using sysref cursor, you just have to create a cursor variable and nothing else. Sysref cursor completely minimizes the first step where you create the weak ref cursor type. Let's do an example and try to learn how to create PLSQL sysref cursor in Oracle database. We will do the same example which we did in the last tutorial, but this time we will be using the sysref cursor instead of weak ref cursor. Let's do it then. Here we are. If you compare this declaration section with the one we created in the last tutorial, you will notice that everything is same except for the missing weak ref cursor declaration, and that is because of the sysref cursor. As said above, sysref cursor is a predefined weak ref cursor, which means it is already defined in a standard package in your Oracle database software. You don't need to declare it in your code. You simply have to write the name of your cursor variable. It can be anything you like, followed by the reserved phrase sys_ref_cursor. And then the semicolon for ending the statement. In our case, the name of our cursor variable is cur_var. This variable will work in the same way as any other cursor variable of weak ref cursor type. One more thing, I have seen people doing this mistake, so I think it's worth mentioning here. There is no space between ref and cursor. It is a single word, ref cursor. So make sure to write it as it is shown to you on your screen, otherwise you will get an error. Now that we are done with the declaration section, let's write the execution section. Here it is. This execution section is exactly the same as that we wrote in the example of the last video. Anyways, let me quickly explain it to those of you who haven't watched the last tutorial. This section has four statements. First statement is the open for statement, using which we are opening our cursor for the select statement, which is returning the first name and the salary of the employee whose employee ID is 100 from the employees table of HR user. Next, the second statement is a fetch statement. In this statement, we are fetching the data from the cursor into the variable fname and empsal. The third statement is the close statement, which will close the cursor and relinquish all the resources held by it. And the fourth statement is an output statement. This statement is displaying back the first name and the salary of the employee which we fetched using our cursor. That's all we have in this section. So, if we compare this code with the one we saw in the last tutorial, everything is same except here we didn't declare any weak ref cursor. Let's execute and see the result. But before that, I request you to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more interesting videos if you haven't already. That being said, now let's execute and see the result. Here we are. Now, you must be wondering, why we need a weak ref cursor when we have a sys ref cursor? Go ahead and check out the blog whose link is in the description to find out the answer. That is the tutorial on how to create PL SQL sys ref cursor in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.